Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So if you watched my last video, it's the single person get home bag that I have in the fanny pack. And in that video, I mentioned that I have that for if I have to get out in a hurry. And I have a larger pack for if I can grab stuff or if I have my family with me, stuff like that. Well, that's what this pack is. I'm going to sit you down and we will go through this and I'll show you guys what I got for my little more lengthy trip for a get home bag. All right, guys, so let's start off with the outside of the bag here. Here I've got a just a little solar panel strapped on to the little bit of molly that's on the front right here with one of the I think it's modal or however you say it, their strap, and then a couple D-rings. The bag itself is a Ruckin River. It's kind of like their Grand Man series, but it's an expandable. So I think it goes from like 35 to 65 liters or something. I'm not 100% sure on that, but something like that. Super high quality YKK zippers. There are several things I don't like about this bag, so I'm not completely sold on it right now for my get home bag. The glaring problem being there's no water bottle holders on the outside of the pack, which in Texas, water is key. So that kind of throws an issue there. And the second being, that it does not have a, hip belt. Or I guess, I'm sorry. Yes, it does. Never mind. I lost track of thought there. Oh, these are kind of thin. Especially if you're gonna have a long trek ahead of you, those are kind of thin, but not awful. You know, better than just regular like straps. But so that's bag and the outside bag all together. Not much going on. Just trying to keep it as simple as possible. And this does live in the toolbox of my truck, so I don't want a whole lot of stuff outside. So this little front pouch here, it lays down. Got a little admin section, mesh pouch, pocket for pins and stuff like that. Let's see, in here I've just got a little hank of survivor cord. This is a Gear Aid microfiber towel. Cover you from the sun while you're moving, dry off, cool down, you know, get it wet, pop it a couple times. It's supposed to cool down when you pop it a couple times or something like that. We got it in a battle box. This is a strap for one of the things in the bag that you'll see as part of the water system. Here is an emergency poncho and a small Apoca box. It's pretty much looks just like the Uber Leben folding twig stove. And here is the lid for the cup. A little survival first aid. If you are having to abandon your vehicle and you're on the move, you may not be thinking completely straight. So something like that to reference back to is great. So that's everything in that pack. Pouch, pocket. We'll put all this stuff back later. This next pouch, or zipper pouch, it's a lot bigger, but you see it's only got the mesh thing, so. In the bag, I have the Taurus. Which one is this one? I don't remember. We got it in a battle box. I really like this knife. 90-degree spine, full tank construction, G10 handles. I don't remember the steel. Razor sharp. I like this little thing. Comes with a super nice leather sheath. You can belt carry with or scout carry. And then on the back here, I've got a canvas sewing needle, or sail needle. Here's just a couple of super bivy bags. One's from MyMedic, one's an off-brand. These will get me through most of the year in Texas with proper proper clothing when I leave the house. Plus, these will cover me for temperature-wise. I've got other shelter items, but yeah. And here is another hank of, so I think this is the 1100 cord, I believe. Don't hold me to it, but it's 550 or 1100. Either way. And here I've got some just aluminum tent stakes. I'm missing one. There's only three here, so we're gonna have to fix that. But yeah, just lightweight. Don't have to worry about making them off the lane or anything like that. And then here is the pocket rod. If you guys go back and watch the video I did on this, I've got all kinds of stuff in there to be able to fish. And I know most places if I go somewhere and I need this big bag on my way home, there's creeks, tanks, lakes, all out there. So just an easy, quick way to get some food maybe. If you are out there for somewhat of an extended period of time. So that's the two small pouches. And then, so you cinch everything down, and you expand the bag. So there is a little bit of molly here and a little bit of molly on the front. And that's it. It's not a very tactical bag. They leaned hard into the gray man on this one, but I don't even have it on both sides. So, and then here's where you split to make it, deeper. Lay it down. I kind of like how this folds over the zippers, but at the same time I don't. It's kind of a pain, but I like how it protects them a little bit better. You know, they won't snag and rip your pack open or anything like that. So it does do a fairly complete clamshell opening. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna start here at the top. I don't know if you can see, but it's got these little buckles in here that you cinch everything down with to the back of the bag. And I've just got a couple things up here at the top that I'll need quickly. Ran through the molly on it. So first, this is the fire kit for the bag. This little bag is from Temu, actually. It looks a lot like my, I got one almost just like it in BattleBox. I can't remember the brand name. But this little thing's almost exactly like it. The stitching's actually pretty good. The zippers are heavy duty. It's just not a name brand from China. So in here, and like, as you can see, there's still lots of room in here. So in here I've got my big 3/8 inch by 6 inch Bayite ferro rod. A couple of the SOL gel fuel tablets, or however you want to say it. It's like the S-Pit, but it doesn't smell like dead fish. The obligatory Bic lighter, a fire bellow. I'm trying to go through this as quick as I can, guys. If y'all want like a detailed breakdown of any of this, let me know and I will go through it slowly. Just there's a lot of stuff in here and I don't want the video to be 2 hours long. Here is the Sasquatch rope. It's a hemp infused fire starter. This is called a dragon's tongue. I got it from a pocket box, and then some UCO storm matches. And then down here at the bottom, you got a baggie with some ProCamTech fire plugs, Bigfoot Bushcraft fire plugs, and these are like the cotton makeup remover patches that 100% cotton that are soaked in lighter fluid and then paraffin wax for a fire starter. So they stay lit forever. Kind of works the same way, same general idea as a cotton ball of Vaseline, just in my opinion a little cleaner to store. You don't have to worry about it, you know, melting and getting everywhere. So that's the fire kit for this bag. Like I said, if you want me to dive deeper into any of this stuff, give you a full review, let me know, and we'll get a video out with that on it too. Next up is my navigation. So this is just a little mag pouch that I turned into my little navigation kit that I could throw on my belt or on the outside of the pack, whatever. Velcro open. So in here we've got a whistle, a indoor signal mirror, and I don't know the brand of this. I don't think it says it on here. No, it doesn't. But it is a lensatic compass. It's got the magnifying glass. Behind this is the mirror. Bevel points north. It's on a lanyard, and on the lanyard you got a little little flashlight to help you see at night. In the mirror, you know, first aid, signaling. It's got the notch in here. You should ask for it. So. And like I said, I don't know the name brand of this. I'm not even 100% sure where I got this, but yeah. So that's the navigation pouch. Oh, no, that's not everything in there. Down here in the bottom, I got a couple things. So this is like 6-8 feet of flagging tape. Like we, you know, if you have to leave the trail or whatever, you got a little thing of flagging tape with you. Some Kim lights, mini ones for, again, marking the trail if you need to. Something for somebody to see if they're walking through at night looking for you or something, maybe. And then here on the back side, weaved in the side of the Molly, I've got it's the little battle box. It's basically like flag tape, but it's got a it's a little more reflective, and it's got a little alligator clamp with it, so keep that in there too. There's only two of them, so not a whole lot there, but you know, if you use it with all the other stuff, you can go a pretty good ways off the trail and still be able to find your way back. I'm gonna try to keep all these together as much as I can, because I will lose them. There we go. And like I said, that is the navigation kit. Right, next in here is my little survival kit. Did a video on this a while back. Go check that out if you want to see what's in here. Jam-packed full of all kinds of stuff. Definitely enough to keep you sustained for at least 24 hours if this is all you had. You could stretch it to a lot more, but all right. And then here is the, obviously, the medical bag. I'm not gonna pull everything out of here again, just for sake of not having a forever long video. But it's got some zips, the bleed stop, medication mods. It's got a rat tourniquet down here. Some Q-tips and an Israeli bandage. And then here I've got some topical creams, earplugs, prep pads, burn shield, sunscreen, stuff like that. If you want me to go into detail on this one, let me know and we'll break it down a little better. Okay, so here is my largest container, water container. And like I said, this doesn't have a pouch on the outside for a water bottle, so I got this little thing off of Temu. Works pretty good. It's got a little Molly deal, snaps in. It'll ride like that. The reason I want this bottle with me is, for one, I can store stuff in it, and if I need to, I can collapse it down to teeny tiny. So on the lid for this, these are the model water bottles, like the band on the outside. There's so many different options and, you know, different things that they offer. It's a really cool deal. Like, I have a shower head. This is the you hook your, it's like a water, makes it like a water bladder. You hook a hose to it, and you got the mouthpiece. So I like that. It, they're not metal, but they also, it's a pretty thick plastic, so I'm not really that worried about it. And then on the inside of here, I'll just start pulling some stuff out. Need to go through it anyway, really. Electrolyte and energy powder from MRE. A liquid IV. I am in Texas. Today's December the 13th, 14th. And right now it's like 75 degrees outside, sunshine, so. Electrolytes and all that, that's pretty important. Here is the, remember this is for the, I think it goes with the hose, but a little straw. Here is the, so I pull this out without pulling everything else out with it. It's not looking so good. And also here's some P&G purifier of water. Each packet treats 10 liters or 2.5 gallons of water. I'm trying to get the, there we go. So I have this fit down in there. And like I said, this goes over the lid for this, or the cap for this. Goes over it. There's an adapter in here somewhere, I think, but the gist of it is this tube goes on here. This end goes, has the mouthpiece on it. This is your drinking end. Got a couple of clips and stuff to keep it, snugged up to the bag and stuff like that, to keep it from bouncing around. My table's not very big. I'm running out of room. And then I've got six of the Aqua Tabs. This is a Wazoo water bag with the Ranger band wrapped around it. I've got a couple of those in here. Yeah, I got a couple of these. Actually, this is, yeah, this is the same one. I like these. They don't have a, they don't have like a roll top or like a bread tie or something like the other bags or the Worldpac bags, but these, you can boil these. Though they're good for up to like 300 or 400 degrees. Obviously, that's not over an open fire where the flame's hitting the bag, but you can boil in these. Go check out the Gray Bearded Green Beret. He does a pretty cool deal of how to set it up so you can boil just that bag. And then here is, I got the Sawyer Mini. So what the plan is so I don't have to worry about stopping and filtering my water and then putting it in a different container a couple times. I could put this in line with the tube, run it through there, and drink it straight out of the model and be good to go. And that's everything on the inside. It does have lids on both sides, and it is like it's super collapsible. Push all the air out, put the cap on, and it does a pretty good job of holding. But that is the kind of my more advanced water kit for that, for this bag. Keeping with the water, so this is also a Temu pouch, but it's like the Pathfinder canteen or the water carrier, whatever. So here on the outside, outside pocket, I've got some, I got two of these Mountain Ops Lemonades Hydration Enhancer, another whistle, and you see on the inside of the pouch too, it's got like little mollies in there. This is pretty heavy duty. It's not white. I mean, obviously it's not YKK zippers, but it's not far from it. And the strap that I pulled out of that small admin pouch goes to this, so I could just throw this crossbody and roll on and go get some water if I need to without having to pack everything or just carry it by hand. Got a couple more of the water filter or water purification tablets and a little thing of duct tape. The duct tape can't fix it, it's broke. Right. And this is my preferred water carry style. Get the bag out of the way. Hang on just a second, guys. I did forget one thing in the that was in the front of that water pouch. This is a Rapid Pure water purification system. This one is brand new, never been used. Still has the wrapper on the filter. I think these are, I think they do viruses and everything, if I'm not mistaken. Which, you know, the Sawyer system and the Life Straws, they don't. They're just dudes like Giardia and bacteria stuff. These actually remove viruses, chemicals, all that stuff from water. That stays in there just as a backup. So here is my preferred. So I've got the Pathfinder and Grail came together and did a stainless steel cup. That's what the lid is for, and obviously if I do stop and cook anything on the pit, this would be or any, you know, cooking in any of the boiling water for freeze dried meals or anything, this would be my container to boil in. It's made for the cup is made for the GeoPress, which is the big grail. But I only have one of those, and I use it more than just, you know, for a truck bag or whatever. So this is the Ultra Press. Take a microfiber rag, lay it over the top of it, push it down in there. Fits just fine, not coming out, and it eliminates the rattle. But I love GeoPress. They're amazing. It's definitely the easiest and the fastest way to purify water. And like I said, it does do viruses and all that stuff. It's super easy, super fast, like 10, 15 seconds. And you can replace the filter. Now they have a little silicone cup you can put down in there so you can add drinks to the bottle without compromising the filter, which is something that they hadn't done in the past. But yeah, that's my preferred way. Next is kind of like a possibles pouch. Here is a Hanka paracord from the my Medic hiker kit. I'll tell you what, I'm gonna do a separate video on this because this is good, this will take forever. There's a lot of stuff in here, so I'm gonna do a separate video of this. Look for that in the next couple, the coming weeks. Yeah, it's big and it's full. So we'll hit this later. All right, next is just a little folding saw. It's not a Bako or a Silky or a Corona or anything. I think I got this from Tractor Supply. Used it a couple times. Works great. You know, the lock is, you know, leaves a little to be desired, but like I said, it's also not a $90 saw that's just gonna sit in my bag. Little lanyard here with fire cord. These are high carb steel with the sharp spines. You can strike a ferro rod, a rock off of it, and use the cord in here, the fire strand in here, to light your fire. Alright. This will be the one thing that'll be updated for sure, just seasonal. This is a change of clothes. Really thick overshirt, really thick pants. These are FR pants, so they're thicker denim. And then a good pair of wool socks. This is in, if I'm in like dress clothes or something and something happens, I could change into this. But my normal everyday clothes I have on are gonna fit the environment. So this is just for backups, or if I need to put an extra layer on, or like I said, if I am in dress clothes and have to change, there you go. Let's see, here is shelter. So this is the Pathfinder emergency bivy tarp. It's the Mylar on one side, orange on the other. The bag it came in. It's not huge, but really what I would use this for, so there's orange, there's the shiny side, and it's got a ridgeline in there with it, pre-made ridgeline. The grommets are terrible on these things. You can reinforce them with duct tape. Dave Canterbury has a whole video about that. So this is a Pathfinder tarp, but this would be signaling, yes, and then a possible fire heat deflector back onto me, or ground mat for me to lay on, in the winter, I don't want to lay directly on the ground, or it's wet and I don't want to get my clothes all wet and everything through the night. Be a good ground sheet. And the overhead to that shelter, so I've got something to sleep in and something to sleep on. Now I need something to sleep under. This is the Creek Stewart Bug Out 72 tarp. It's a weird shape. It's almost like a hexagon kind of shape, but it's big. It's sturdy. It came with guy tie-outs and stakes. And I've used it. When I first got it, I put it up and used it for, played with it for a little bit, and it's awesome. Heavy-duty ripstop material. It's pretty bright in color, too, so you could, depending on your environment, it would work for some signaling too. But so, ripstop nylon, double stitched around the, it's got the I don't even know what you call those, like the edge saver, I don't know. But heavy, really heavy duty. Like that it came with all the equipment too. I don't have to really worry about it. But I do have those tent stakes if I need them. And then here's just a little bit of food. Lifeboat, 2,400 calories, 5-year shelf life, all that good stuff. We all know these are hard as a rock. Probably tastes like crap, but yeah. When you're on the move, it is what it is. This next thing, I'm adding to it, actually. What did I do with it? Okay, so we're gonna pretend that it's in here. So this is a dry bag from Silent. And what they do is, their main thing is Faraday bags. Silent. It is the Silent Pocket. So I don't know what it did with it, but in here is going an old iPhone, a battery bank, and the cord. I have like screenshots of the maps around here. I have apps that don't need internet or anything to run. I've got a list of several things in there, emergency stuff. Like I said, now I do have the a battery bank and the cord to go with it. I just don't know what I did with it. I just charged it again and brought it back out here, and I don't know what I did with it, but okay. Yeah, so that takes care of everything in the get home bag. On the one I did for the single person, I got a lot of comments saying, you know, where's your already made water, where's food, whatever. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a series. This is going to be a series, so this will be a second video in the series. And then we'll go from here to the gear I keep in the outside of my truck, and then we'll go to what I keep inside my pickup, because that's where all of my stuff like that is. And I can already hear everybody, all the keyboard warriors saying, all this stuff is brand new, it's never been used, yada yada yada, all that stuff. Well, this hasn't been used. These haven't been used, but they're duplicates of things that I have that have been used, that I've tried out for years, and I really liked them, and so I got duplicates to put in my get home bag. So it's not, I'm not using this every day, I'm not using it as a camping bag or anything like that. This is solely dedicated to that, so that if I take any, so I can't take anything out of it and forget to put it back. So yeah, everything in here is brand new except for really the knife, and that's for a reason. I want unused good quality stuff to get me home. I don't have to worry about if it's overused and it's about to go or whatever. So so keep an eye out for upcoming videos for that. I just decided I'm gonna do that. It'd be easier than explaining everything that's in the truck. So I appreciate you guys sticking around this long. If you have, I might break this up into two videos, I'm not sure yet. But if you're sticking around this long, thank you. Like, share, subscribe, leave a comment down below. If you're not subscribed, please consider subscribing. I know most of the people that watch my videos aren't, so it's free, costs nothing to you, no sweat off your back. So would really appreciate it, helping the channel grow. I'm not sponsored by anybody, so all this comes out of my pocket. Battle Box and everything, I pay for it out of my pocket. Appreciate it, guys. Let me know if you want to go deeper into any of these pouches, and we'll go from there. Thanks, guys. God bless.